Hello people, you are most welcome again on my channel. And today I am going to start a series for history of English literature, and hopefully it will help a lot of students. And there will be only one request from you all, that please share this series with other students too. I want to tell you that this book is very important, and I cleared my most of English literature portion in my teaching exams, whether it was KVS, NVS and DSSB and my state government lecturer exam and my LT exam. I cleared those exams just because of this book. So I want to help others too. This book I got in 2013 from it is well organized, like you can see the early Renaissance and topic wise what is Renaissance, poetry, prose, the educationist, the reformers, drama, everything you will see here. Like in Age of Shakespeare you will see essay, philosophical prose. See, so here in next portion you will see here. Okay, this is well organized book. The topics are well organized up to Victorian, and then finally you will come to the Age of Interrogation and Anxiety, the modern age. Now just I want to start a series for English literature so that it will help you all. So hopefully you will be with me for a long time, and in 1 or 2 months we will be completing this whole book in depth. Every topic I will teach you from this book. And the second book I want to do is this one. This is again an old book, but and this book, History and Principles of Literary Criticism by Dr. Raghukul Tilak. Here this book helped me making my concept clear about literary criticisms. And another book is M.H. Abraham. If you don't have, download it or buy it. Okay, so these books helped me a lot in clearing my most of exams in KVS, NVS and other exams, my state government, Uttarakhand government exams. And I give credit to these books which helped me in my self-study, and through my self-study I accumulated enough knowledge for clearing the exam. But still, after reading these books, I really like English literature, studying English literature. So I created this channel to share my knowledge and to discuss with you all. Whatever good comments and bad comments, both helps me, both motivate me to keep going on, and it helps me a lot in learning. So from tomorrow I will be doing some lessons, and we will start from here, English literature before Chaucer. As you can see here, I have marked some important things here, and I will tell you these all important notes. So here you can see I have marked this whole book. This is the first book I studied. After this book I have studied 6 to 7 books on the same topic, history of English literature. One by one I will be sharing these books with you, and hope this will help you a lot. So jo bhi yahan par notes hain, I hope you will note down those notes, and in 2 months or 3 months from this point of time, from tomorrow, I will start the first chapter. Okay, the first chapter, as you can see here, the first chapter is English literature before Chaucer. Okay, and we will start from here, and in at least 2 months, we will take 2 months, and every day you will find a topic, you will make a notebook, and you will make your own notes, you will remember those things. And please do write in comment box that whether how many people wants this series, and this will motivate me that some people are getting help from my videos, And really, I appreciate those people who messaged me after clearing their exams that, so you really helped us through my videos and through my notes from my website, cozystudy.blogspot.com. I'm thankful to those. And I want to say that it is not me who is helping. It is your dedication towards your studies. I just provide some material, whatever I can do. Alright, so let's go ahead. Let's help some other people. Whatever we know, let's share. Write down in comment box. And if you have some suggestions, please do write down in comment box. Bye-bye. Take care. Good luck for exams. And happy learning.